Hello there, welcome to another Contacts with Conway. My name is Martin Conway, and in this video, we continue my earlier conversation with Dr. Tom Arnold from Sugarland in Texas. In the first part of the conversation, Tom described the use of technology to allow the empirical fitting of scleral contact lenses. In this, the second half of that conversation, he goes on to describe his wish list for contact lens materials, the use of a revolutionary new hydropeg coating on specialist lenses, and then we go on to discuss a new material recently launched onto the specialist lens market. If you would prefer to watch this video with subtitles, please click on the cog in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen and select your preferred language.
And what about these new lenses now, this new generation of lenses? What about the materials that you're using currently?
Well, I think in the last couple of years, it's been a very exciting time. I think materials is a very, very important thing. And as you well know, Contimax been really great about introducing new materials that are stiffer. We want a stiff lens that can be cut thin to allow oxygen. We want high decay lenses, stable materials, and that there's been, you know, great leaps and advances in that area. And then, of course, we have the really, really good coatings like tangible hydropeg, and I'm a big fan of hydropeg.
I think that's probably focus. It's coincided nicely with the arrival of this interest in scleral lenses.
There's a point to talk, and this is interesting. A lot of people have dry eyes, of course. A lot of keratoconus people are atopic, and, you know, we fit scleral lenses for ocular surface disease. That's an indication for it. And, you know, a couple of points about that. You put a large diameter scleral lens on an eye. What's that do to the lid wiper? You know, what's that do to the blink of the eye? You know, it certainly, you know, pushes the eyelid forward, and the eyelid is coming down and interacting not with the corneal surface, but with the surface of that lens.
Yeah.
So coatings are important, but I think there's a lot of work that has been done and still to be done in the material science itself, you know, to make the material lubricious, so we could use kind of a made up word, you know, but yeah. Make it lubricious in and of itself, because as good as hydropeg is, and I'm a huge fan, and I've spoken for hydropeg for tangible science, as good as it is, you well know that in patients with severe dry eyes, severe atopy, you know, I'm going to go see a guy later this morning after we finish this talk with ocular cicatricial pemphigoid. You know, and his eye is a disaster, Stevens-Johnson syndrome. And so hydropeg doesn't last, you know, all that long in patients that have poor tear. Now they're coming out with Boost, which is a monthly, you know, replenishment. We're just waiting on that, and that will help. But I think, you know, companies like Contimax still have work to do in the basic, you know, plastic science. Yeah. Chemical engineering.
We, as you know, we put a lot of effort into R&D. The latest addition to the Optimum range has been the Infinite, which it's different to what's gone before. Most of the materials, both from us and competitors, have all used a basic silicon molecule called Tris. This material uses a more expensive monomer. It's a styrene tris monomer, which gives us more oxygen, but it gives thickness. With a conventional tris monomer, if we keep increasing silicon, then what happens? The material starts to flex. And it's the last thing you want to happen, either with an ortho-K lens or in particular with a scleral lens, where you're actually inducing astigmatism because of the flexure. Obviously, the stiffer we can make the material, the thinner we can make it. Again, that's going to be a boost to the oxygen coming through it. And overriding all of this is we have to maintain wettability. We have to make this material slippery to the lid to flow over. And again, that's the problem with conventional silicon, is that by its nature, it's dry. We use strong silicon. silicon soft lenses, and it's no different with silicon GP.
Yeah. I was going to tell you an anecdote that'll show my age is as a adolescent, I wore PMMA lenses. Okay. And so did my wife. And when I was in pre-optometry, you know, doing my pre-optometry, studies, I was married at that time, and we're still married, same wife, but we both wore these PMMA lenses, pre-optometry, and we found an optometrist in our college town of Boulder, Colorado. And we went to her, and gas perms had just come out, and they were Polycon, which I'm sure you remember.
Right.
And yeah, we had PMMA lenses, which are like a piece of glass, you know. And I remember my wife getting Polycon lenses, and they just flex like this, you know, like a boomerang. And they were horrible. They flex, they didn't wet, but this was the good thing. So materials have come a long way since Polycon.
Yeah, I mean, one of the lectures that I give, you know, to students and things, I mentioned this, the Polycon, I think it was Syntex was the original lab.
Sounds right.
That launched it.
Yeah, that sounds right.
I think it had a decay of about 8, which was fantastic in those days. But it achieved success, and people saw that the secret to, you know, success was more oxygen. And then we ended up with this almost arms race amongst the manufacturers going, you know, and unfortunately practitioners were carried along with this wave of enthusiasm that they focused so much on decay to the exception of everything else. And I think now we've got enough oxygen. I think that with the likes of Infinite, that we don't get that many problems now with oxygen at those levels.
And now
practitioners are realizing that there are other attributes to the material that we need to focus on, you know, the wettability, the rigidity. Yes. And as you mentioned, this lubricity, which is the new word that we're all using.
Yeah.
Not that we can measure it or tell you what it is, but we all know exactly what we want. And so those are things that we're working on steadily. But these things take time. So we've just recently put Infinite out there, and we're getting good feedback from that. And so based upon that, then that will decide where we go next. You know, have you had any experience with the Infinite material? Have you tried it?
Oh, I have. Yeah, I was going to tell you, I'm a big fan. Yes, I've used it a number of times. It's pretty much, I want to say in most cases, it's a lens of choice. It's certainly a lens of choice when I fit a post-RK, you know, we're worried about neovascularization, certainly the material of choice in the grafts, the PKs, PKPs, you know, when oxygen is a premium. And I find, as you said, the material is fine. It's not less wettable because of higher decay. It's not more flexible. It's a great material.
It is, yeah.
There's no reason, you know, no reason not to use it, in my opinion.
Thank you for watching this conversation with Dr. Tom Arnold. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, please remember to like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you next time. Thank you very much.